Lucent and Roads and Transport Authority, Javad. Javad.
Assalamu alaikum. My name is Javad Sadi. I'm from RTA, Director of Military Enforcement. I'm here today to share with you one of our projects related to the monitoring and enforcement and roadside inspection for heavy vehicles. This project actually called Vehicle Defect Clearing Services, or VDCS. To give you an overview about this project, this project aimed to improve traffic safety level on road by reducing heavy vehicle incident and negative effects, and raise the level of safety and security on road by detecting heavy vehicle defects through developing full solution of effective policies and smart system, which will analyze vehicle defects through a model scheme. Actually, there is a goal of this project is to enhance safety on roads and reduce heavy vehicle incidents, strengthen infrastructure of Dubai and the UAE, reducing the financial, human and environmental risk and damages caused by heavy vehicles. Actually, to run this project, we have different inputs where we connect all data. We have annual testing that is conducted by partners, vehicle inspection centers, and we have new things will come up inshallah, which is a remote defect detector, a telematic device would be fixed on the heavy vehicle to collect all required data, and roadside inspection. Along with that, there is a set of new policies and parameters will be set to measure those defects and analyze it. Output of that will be, we will have a database called BSD, Vehicle Safety Database, that can be used by our inspector while doing their job in the roadside inspection. In this project actually, what we are going to monitor, we will monitor driver status, behavior, location, temper status, and incidents, rather than some technical information we might be collected from this technology. On the other hand, we have also something called OVRR. OVRR is a mechanism used to calculate likelihood of vehicles and operate an operator being non-compliant with the regulation and standards of safety, and also can be used by the roadside inspection of RTA to identify vehicles that should be checked and enforce certain safety criteria for non-compliance vehicles. How it's going to work? Based on a set of defined criteria, each vehicle is given score as a show, green, amber, and red, and with numeric value of from 0 to 10. So for example, R10 is the most critical score. The objective of this risk rating mechanism is to reduce the load on the compliance operator and vehicle, and targeted non-compliance with more efficiency and increased number of compliance vehicles in the road of Dubai. Finally, here we have the life cycle of VDCs. You can see from the system and from this roadside inspection, we will detect all this. We will stop the vehicles. Each inspector has a device, handheld device, connected to this system. It can show the historical data of this vehicle, what's the defects, what's the historical defects before, and how many times did the passing in the centers. Based on that, the inspector will do visual inspection and check whether all these defects been cleared. Based on that, there's a recording using the handheld as a mission, and there is a fine might be issued and grounded vehicle for non-compliance. Meanwhile, we will send system will send alert to the operator. Some vehicle which will be pulled to the test center again to check whether is it safe to be on road. If anybody or any operator didn't bring this cars for the inspection, we will send them alert. There will be a penalties of non-compliance. And there is an administration step where we can share all this information with our operator to help them improve themselves, improve the heavy vehicle security, generating reports, and also collecting funds. My presentation was too short, actually. This is actually a new project for RTA. We are going to start, inshallah, this month by setting or designing the policies, and also in the same time we will share those drafts with some of the operators. We were testing different technologies, I mean telematics devices, what is the suitable devices will be fitted in the system. And also on the other hand, we have also a ready system called the VSD database, vehicle testing database, which will have all historical data of this vehicles. This system also connected to another system called CIS, Centralized Inspection System, in all centers in Dubai. We are collecting all test results from this center, and to see whether how many times this vehicle has been failed, how many times, what is the maximum failure cause of those vehicles. And thank you very much, and I'm ready to the questions.
So gentlemen, do you have any questions on this important topic? Gentlemen here.
Yes, thanks for the presentation. I have a question regarding the telematics system. Is it something which is going to be mandatory for all trucks registered in Dubai, and how this will work?
Yes.
Who is the supplier? What kind of information do you want to collect?
Yes. Actually, it will be mandatory for all the commercial vehicles in Dubai. And we have a plan. We will start gradually. We're not going to enforce it for everyone from day one. We will select it, the older vehicles, then the newer. So in this year, we have we're targeting the vehicles over 20 years. Heavy vehicle over 20 years. Meanwhile, we will measure also the, we have a stage where we are going to evaluate those telematics devices. We might call many vendors. And as you know, there is lots of vendors providing this telematic device. What we want to do, we want to have the correct one, the more efficient, and also we will consider the price of this device. We don't want to also put overhead on the operators.
So it has not been finally selected about the characteristics of the telematics device?
Yes, yes. As I mentioned in the presentation, there is some specification for this the telematic device, where we are going to monitor some defects, where we want to monitor driver behavior as well. As you know, everybody knows that driver behavior is the most important things. Not necessarily you have a right vehicle or safe vehicle. Driver should be monitored. Driver should be having some measure of criteria to measure his behavior.
Similar like bus
and car rental, yes.
Before, a big part of the vehicle population in the UAE this telematic device together with such old technology vehicles? Is it possible, is it feasible that this telematic device will gather the information necessary from vehicles with such old technology?
Yes. There is different telematic devices, as I mentioned. Some telematic devices are connected to the computer of the vehicle, and some of it is not. So, of course, we will put some needed sensor to measure what part. And as I mentioned also, we have different another input, which is the animal testing center. We are collecting also data from those centers.
By the manufacturer, or that we provide it here in you in the RTA?
No, there is only different selected vendors which will work with RTA.
Okay. Hello, thank you very much for the very interesting information. When it comes to telematics, of course, there's set of data which is available for every truck, from every truck,
yes,
and for each and every one, every telematic system. But also some manufacturers are offering their in-house solutions,
yes,
which are bringing a large number of data which is not possible to get from any third-party solutions. If you would introduce your selected vendor, would it mean that solutions from manufacturers which can provide even more data,
definitely,
can they be used as well?
Yes. Actually, it's open wide for anyone can help us to reach our goals. Our goals is the safety goals. So it's not necessary telematic device with minimum or limited function. Some of the vehicles has already was tracking, G-force gauges or what, different specification, so it can give you what information you need. So those vehicles will be not necessarily fix the telematic fast, you can get it easily from them.
The reason for my question is, of course, looking at the benefit of the operator and the fleet manager, because he will also not benefit only from the safety,
yes,
but also for the efficiency.
Yes, sir. Actually, we are considering the efficiency of operator, and also we are taking care of the
operator. Thank you very much.
Pick up one point. You were in charge of vehicle inspections, I think, at the beginning of the year. Yeah.
No, actually.
What I'm interested in is the size of the problem, the number of violations, for example, that has been identified.
Actually, we have a daily roadside inspection. We are checking maybe 200 vehicles per day. Issuing to violation. Actually, most of the vehicles are not most of the vehicles. It's not necessary to buy vehicles. All other Emirates, all other countries also. The most important thing for us, of course, is the safe. Those vehicles, how safe those vehicles, don't
need to buy. How many violations have you picked up
from
beginning
of the year?
1,800 average of the month. So we're getting on to about 45,000 violations.
Yes.
There's obviously a need for this kind of
thing.
Certainly.
So why we're introducing this again? To reduce the violations.
Yeah, of course. And indeed, it's very interesting to hear you speak of in the United Kingdom. We have a similar project that you have here. And the IMI works with the Department of Transport and other government to deliver better road safety through roadside inspections and MOT. For operators in the United Kingdom and other countries, of course, the need to conform to the compliance of the regulators in this case is really important, because the penalties can be quite severe, in the sense that if you do not meet the regulations quite properly, and quite properly designed by the government to improve road safety and efficiency, then your business is at risk. So, you know, it's a kind of sting in the tail. Let's make sure that we support our colleagues in the Department of Transport and make this a better industry for everyone. procedure with the flight cameras.